Hi guys, here is part two. I'm taking another short story that I wrote and we'll be going through it. That way you guys can be able to write your own. Let's get started. Mark was glad his uncle only lived a quarter of a mile down the road. It was hard to steal a car when you didn't have a car to get you there in the first place. Well, he wasn't really stealing it, just borrowing it for the weekend. His uncle wouldn't even know that it was gone anyway. It was one of those classic cars that people collect but don't drive. The first sentence gets you interested in the story by making you wonder why Mark is glad that his uncle only lives a quarter of a mile away. Also notice that the character is introduced in the first sentence as well, and that this story is in third person and not first person, so that makes it a lot easier to be able to tell the gender of the character. The second sentence tells what the character wants, and it also further intrigues the reader. I mean, hey, car theft is exciting. Now, this want is a little bit different than it was in my first example, because this isn't the character's main want. It's simply a step that he has to take before he can get what he actually wants, but we'll talk about that more later on. Mark walked down the long dirt driveway, typical of small towns in the south, and hoped that the coyotes he heard last night had moved on. He swallowed and reminded himself why he was here. Shannon, the most gorgeous girl in his high school. She moved here from Manhattan in the middle of the school year, and Mark instantly fell in love. Flawless skin, smooth dark hair, cherry red lipstick, and a fashion sense the bumpkins around her could only dream of. She was like a girl out of a TV show. Notice that the first line indicates where the story takes place without just coming straight out and saying he was in the South. It also puts a possible obstacle in the way, coyotes. The second paragraph gives his main want, which is Shannon. This is the reason that he needs the car. Unfortunately, Shannon didn't seem to think as highly of him as he did of her. She pretty much ignored him for most of the school year. But all of that changed when she told him she'd go out with anyone in this town who was romantic enough to take her on a surprise beach getaway for the weekend. Well, she hadn't really told him. He was one of the many people that sat at Shannon's lunch table to listen to her cute northern accent and fawn over her worldly knowledge, but he was the only one who actually planned a beach trip for this weekend. He told her about it in school that morning, palms wet, insides quivering. When she said she'd go with him, it was all he could do not to jump up and down. He told her that he'd pick her up tonight. The only problem was, even though he was 16, he didn't have a car. His parents wanted him to save up and buy it himself. Notice that the last two paragraphs have been backstory. We started out with Mark sneaking out to get the car, and then we went on to talking about his crush and how he got into the situation in the first place. There are two reasons for this. One is that starting out talking about a car theft is a lot more exciting than starting out talking about a school crush. Remember, you want to make your first couple of lines really, really draw readers in. And the second reason is that starting the story out where Mark meets Shannon, or where he overhears her saying that she wants to go to the beach, or even where he goes up to her and asks if she would go to the beach with him, would be starting the story out too early. Remember, you always want to start your story right before it ends. Once Mark gets the car, he gets Shannon. Always start the story out right before your character makes the big move to get them what they want. The turkey presents an obstacle to what he wants. Always make sure your characters have obstacles in getting whatever it is that they want. Even if it's something small, it doesn't have to be big. It can even be comical like it is in this example. Just never let your characters walk right in and get what they want with no problems. Mark jumped into the shed and shut the door before the turkey followed. Mark rubbed his sore leg and told himself that it would all be worth it once he had Shannon in the car beside him. He made a playlist of romantic oldies for them to listen to on his iPod. And with all the hours that he'd have her alone in the car, he was sure he'd work up the courage to tell her how he felt. He grabbed the keys from its hiding place in the gas tank and cranked the car. Mission successful. Mark imagined Shannon sitting next to him the whole way to her house. When he pulled into her driveway, he was surprised to see two girls standing beside Shannon on her porch. They both had suitcases in their hand. I can't wait to feel the sand between my toes, Shannon said, handing Mark her suitcase. Me too, her friend squealed. Shannon, Mark said, struggling with the large suitcase. I thought it was just going to be me and you. Of course not, silly. Shannon flounced to the car. How boring would that be? She settled herself in the back seat, and her friend sat on either side of her. Mark spent the drive listening to Katy Perry and staring at the empty passenger seat beside him. Again, always in the story, as soon as your character either gets or fails to get whatever they want. In this case, he was successful in getting the first thing he wanted, the car, but because he only wanted that so he could get Shannon to be his girlfriend, in the end, he really wasn't successful at all. His success in getting the car actually makes his failing with Shannon seem even more devastating, because he went through a lot more than if he had just walked up to her house and asked her to go with him. I mean, his uncle's going to be pretty mad that he took the car, right? And he didn't even get the girl. So whether you have your characters fail to get what they want, or if you have them succeed at the end and they get what they want, always make sure that you have some kind of obstacle in their way. Make something exciting happen, make something bad happen to them. You always have to have something bad happen to your character, whether writing a short story or a novel, or the story just isn't interesting. So I hope that these tips helped and that walking through a couple of short stories of my own was useful, and I will see you next time. This introduces an obstacle to what Mark wants. It doesn't have to be anything big. It can even be something comical. Shoot, dang it.